there's a lot of questions that probably come across your mind throughout the day. Did you leave the stove on? Do you have milk in the fridge? And did you email that invoice for your patient? Well, with our communication search, one of those questions can be answered. But yes, you did run out of milk. You don't cook, so the stove is off. In this week's Tip of the Week, I'll show you how you can use the communications page and section on a patient's file to figure out if you successfully emailed or messaged a patient, including how to search by status. Let's do this. To view communications, you'll need to have the right security role / permissions. Currently, all roles can view communications except schedulers and bookkeepers. The communications page, which you can find in the menu, will show emails and SMS messages that have been sent from your account. For example, confirmations, reminders, invoices, letters, account statements, and SMS replies. So if you're not sure if an invoice has been sent, for example, you can search your communications. Simply type in the name of the patient or their email address, and we will then list their communications from newest to oldest. If you click on the date, you'll then see the details of the message, including the communication number, which really helps me and the rest of the support team if you have any questions about a specific communication, as well as the date and time the communication was sent, the type of message, i.e. SMS, letter, invoice, and a copy of what was included in the email. We'll also show things like links in the communication details. This will change depending on the type of message. So if you emailed an invoice, we will display a link to the invoice and the related appointment directly. There are also some unknown search terms that you can use on the communications page. For example, you can see SMS replies from your patients by typing the word inbound or received. Want to see what SMS messages failed? Type the word failed. Just note, if you see a number of failed SMS messages, I recommend checking how many SMS credits are remaining in your account. If you have zero SMS credits, that's usually the reason for the failed status. In summary, the communications page is a great place to check on communications. If you head to a patient's file, within their menu, you'll also see a link to communications. This will show you all of their communications without having to search manually on the communications page. Also, something to note, you cannot delete individual communications from a patient's file. If you delete their file entirely, we will then remove communications, but individual deletions isn't possible. Well, that's it for this week's tip. Let me know if this tip helped, and don't forget to buy milk. I love you all, and I will see you next tip.